She narrowed it down to two speakers, me and Wally Famous Amos. He was busy. We spent a lot of time in southern Louisiana. Recently, we were doing some shopping. I was looking at the men's suits one by one. Very nice gentleman approached me. Sir, hi, I'm a sales associate here. Notice you were looking at the suits, hoping I might assist you in some way. And I turned to him, I said, well, I really appreciate your help, but I just want to be really honest with you. I'm not going to be buying a suit today. He said, may I ask why? I said, well, it's because of the alterations. You see, you know, the arms need to be shortened and tapered, and, you know, it requires such extensive alteration. I just don't believe that I'll be buying a suit, but I thank you for your help. He looks me right in the eye. Sir, well, I'm sure you're aware that most athletic men have that problem. He says, most athletic men have that problem. I said, you are absolutely right. I don't know what I was thinking. So I try to sit on, fit pretty well in the shoulders. The arms were a little long, but I thought, that's no big deal. I decide to purchase this suit. You know why? It's not every day that you work with an expert like this gentleman. I said, is this the type of suit that an athletic man like me should be wearing? He said, yes, sir, and there are several others here in the rack that you must have as well. It was a rather expensive day. But you know, I felt good about it. The Dillard's department store outside of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, has a sign in the men's department. The sign says, we never neglect the lanyard. I asked him what lanyard meant. He chuckled to himself. He said, well, that's a French-Cajun word. He said, we use it a lot here in southern Louisiana. I said, what does lanyard mean? He said, well, if a person went into a place of business, the customer said to the merchant, I'd like a dozen oranges. Well, the merchant may give 13, one extra. Or if they were buying grain, and they asked for 2 pounds. The merchant would fill the bag to the scale register 2 pounds, then would take the scoop one more time into the barrel, then into the sack. The last scoop, that extra orange, was called the lanyard. And lanyard is defined in the French Cajun language as beyond full measure. It means a little extra. The essence of my life is not far different than yours. Handicaps come in many forms: emotional, intellectual, and of course, attitudinal. Wouldn't you agree that some handicaps you can see and some you can't? Boundaries have much more to do with inner limitations than outer circumstances. Our attitudes are the window through which we see our life experience. Now, we're not responsible for everything that happens to us, but I do believe we are responsible for our response to everything that happens to us. Well, during my tennis career, I played Mr. John McEnroe. That's right. And that, my friends, taught me that a resilient attitude does not work every single time. I learned about the power of optimism from a member of our family when I was growing up. I'd like to tell you about her. She has lopsided ears, or had lopsided ears, different colored eyes, and she lived to 14 years of age. It was our dog. The homeliest looking dog you've ever seen, but my mother, bless her heart, gave this homely animal the most elegant sounding name: Soufflé. Soufflé can teach all of us in this audience something about optimism. Every time the doorbell rings, Soufflé ran to answer it, sat on her hind legs and wagged her tail until that door was open. She lived for 14 years, answered every door in the Crawford household. The door was never for her. Optimism. Transcends circumstance.